faculty in Harris expect their students to be mathematically competent. Because the thing about the U of C is that we are on quarters. Classes are only 10 weeks long, and they can come at you pretty fast and furious. And so if you've got a nice running start, that's excellent. We get people coming in from all kinds of different backgrounds, right? People who actually maybe majored in math or econ as undergraduates. People who have been working in government or business for a number of years. People who are coming fresh out of undergrad where, gosh, you know, the last math class they had was in high school. So there's all kinds of backgrounds for students in math camp, and I have to try to address all of that.
This is when the networking for the Harris calendar year begins. Working together on problems involving derivatives and finding solutions to quadratic equations ends up being the start of lifelong friendships.
I mean, yeah, we didn't know any of us before we came here. And I mean, now we like hang out and do math all the time.
My understanding is that they're not required to be here. Students are only required to be here for orientation week. But they are required to pass two exams. One is an algebra / pre-calculus exam, and one is a calculus exam.
Yeah.
I write those exams based on the things that we cover in math camp, but not strictly following the day-to-day business of math camp. But nevertheless, they do have to pass these two tests, whether or not they attend math camp. And so, why not come for a couple of weeks and get to meet your classmates and get to go to some brown bag lunches with some faculty and have the opportunity to work on some math and get all the rust off and be ready for those exams. And so the huge majority of Harris students come for the full math camp. They get their apartments, you know, September in Chicago is beautiful, and you get acclimated to the whole, to Hyde Park and the city and the campus. And by the way, you learn some math.